credit is getting cut off. Stocks are sinking. The housing market is crumbling. And millions have lost their jobs. All signs of an economic crisis. But the question is, how did this happen?
We've attempted to overrule God's economic laws, and we have been broken as a result of violating those economic laws. There are a couple of factors involved, and that is there has been this preoccupation with materialism in our culture. Number two, there is people living way beyond their means. Credit was very, very easy in the United States today.
Economists say Americans' attitude toward money and possessions has shifted.
When I was a youngster, we're taught to save for a rainy day. You shouldn't live from paycheck to paycheck. Put some money away. Only buy what you could afford. If you could not afford it, maybe put it on layaway and put a certain amount of money towards it each week. That's not the lesson today. That is, people believe in instant gratification and they live with the effects of it.
We expect government to solve problems for us that we would be better off solving ourselves. And we demand things that don't belong to us.
Many Americans have relied on the federal government to help them buy what they couldn't afford, and the government has been more than willing to intervene.
We had the federal government with the Community Reinvestment Act that was pushed by Clinton and also pushed by Bush to create affordable housing that forced banks and lending institutions to make high-risk loans that they otherwise would not have made.
Some people couldn't afford to buy a house. They didn't have enough money for the down payment. That we're going to create agencies, Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac, to guarantee the loans to the mortgage companies. And so somebody who didn't have any money could go into a mortgage company, no money down, to get a mortgage because Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac would be there to back up the loan.
You create an artificial demand for housing that directs a whole lot of the economy's resources into the making of housing that otherwise would have been used for other things that people could afford properly. And then as that money keeps going there, you build a bubble, the whole thing bursts, and then it takes an enormous period of very painful readjustment for everyone to get through that bursting of the bubble. Without the laws that forced bankers to give unreasonable loans in the first place, we wouldn't have the bubble. We wouldn't have the sudden painful readjustment for the whole economy.
The free market gets a lot of blame for this economic meltdown, but I believe it's been governmental interference that really disrupted the free market.
This interference with the free market has been made possible because of billions of dollars the government has at its disposal collected from taxpayers. Essentially, this money has been taken forcibly from some Americans in order to give to others.
An action that forcibly takes from one person to give to another person is only lawful under biblical law if it is either in restitution for a crime or in tax support of the proper functions of government, which are to punish those who do wrong, to defend people against aggression, and to praise those who do good, not to spread wealth around. There's no indication anywhere in the Bible that that is the purpose of civil government. And the Eighth Commandment is not, thou shalt not steal unless thou art the government. It's just, thou shalt not steal.
So our government steals from us in a variety of ways. They also, government, steal from us in terms of inflation. When they increase the money supply, like they've done in this bailout, up to $1 trillion, that dilutes the value of money that's already in the system. That's a sense of stealing. Inflation is stealing because it devalues the dollars that we're holding in our hand.
What can Americans do about the current financial crisis, as well as the economic system at large?
For America to get out of this economic dilemma that we're in right now, there are a number of things we need to do. First of all, we need to get our moral house in order and realize that government is not a fountain of free goodies, and we shouldn't be expecting it to do things that are better done ourselves. The current financial mess is not a Republican problem, it's not a Democrat problem, it's a moral problem, and both parties have been complicit in delivering us to this situation. But they're not doing it on their own, because what they're doing is reflective of the general erosion of character across society. We're the ones who elect these people. And we can turn things around only if we demand higher standards and different policies of the people we elect.